Well, as we've been talking about all morning, it's finally eclipse day.
So what exactly will happen here in Philadelphia? Eyewitness News reporter Pat Gallen is live at the Franklin Institute this morning with the answer. Good morning, Pat.
Good morning, guys. Well, I've got a little bit of insider information, actually, which is really cool. So Derek Pitts, the head astronomer here at the Franklin Institute, is actually in St. Joseph's, Missouri. And he didn't want to miss it. He didn't want to take the chance or risk it. So he's actually sleeping in his car, getting ready for the eclipse. That's what you do when you're a scientist. You sleep in your car when there is an eclipse. This is Mickey Maley from the Franklin Institute. Good morning, my friend.
Good morning.
So what are we looking at here? We've got a bunch of different ways to view this thing. Which would you show the people and say, here, maybe something like this you can build on your own?
Absolutely. So if you were lucky enough to be able to get enough material ahead of time to make your own large solar viewer, and a lot of people were looking for glasses, this is the same type of material. It's a silver black polymer, as you mentioned earlier. And this blocks out 99.98% of the light of the sun, making it safe for you to view the sun through this material.
That's a good thing.
Now, we're promoting a lot of really safe viewing practices here at the Franklin Institute. We're going to have lots of safe viewing opportunities at our event between 12 and 4
cool.
outside of the museum on Winter Street, which is a nice newly renovated park here in Philadelphia.
Mm-hmm.
So not only are we going to have viewers like this, we're also going to have canopies that you can stand under with this as the shelter.
Just a giant canopy of that.
Yes. We're going to have
That's a great idea.
So you can stand under them with your friends, your family, come by, come out of your office break for lunch.
Sure.
And, come take a look at the eclipse. We're also going to have sunspotters. These are really great.
Yeah, these are neat.
Almost telescope type viewers. They're very safe to see the surface of the sun.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to have many of these spread out over the course of the day.
So what does it do exactly?
So it'll actually project an image of the surface of the sun onto a piece of paper by pulling it through lenses and bouncing it off of mirrors.
Makes sense.
A great way for us to use all year round so that we can study the surface of the sun and see sunspots. But we're also going to have telescopes. While this is not a major telescopic event,
right.
we want to make sure people have a chance to see the eclipse in the best possible way.
Sure.
So we're going to have telescopes like this one you see over here that'll project an image of the surface of the sun onto this material at the end of our cone. This is going to make it really safe to view. People can watch as groups. And really, that's what we want to be able to do. We want to have a celebration for this event, and we're also going to be able to have people celebrate it together.
Gotta love it. So everyone come down to the Franklin Institute, hang out with Mickey. You can get under the canopy that is made of this silver black polymer. I will never forget what that is called. But most importantly, Mickey, of course,
please do not look directly at the sun without safe viewing tools.
Don't do it.
It's really important.
Don't do it. All right? You guys, Jim and Rahel, I know you're going to try to do it.
We're not looking in the sun directly.
Don't do it.
No. We're all about safety here.
Don't do it.
Wear the glasses. Good stuff, though, Pat. Thank you.